The PS3 has reached the point of being dead. A lot of the game servers are closing down, and the ones that are still up don't have as big of a player base as maybe, say, the same game on the Xbox 360 due to the Xbox One backwards compatibility for popular titles like Call of Duty. Which is why it seems like now Sony has just moved into this slow process of updating the console in a way to keep counteracting the threat of piracy on their systems. And yet again, the 4.84 update for the PS3, the most current update, has been broken, and you are now able to install CFW custom firmware on top of that. Basically, in this video, I'm going to explain the different criteria around each different type of hack you can do on your PS3, what type of experience that's going to give you, and hopefully point you in the right direction with some different tutorials to get you going on the path that you want to take with your PlayStation 3. So these are the criteria for what it takes for a PlayStation 3 to be moddable. Like I said, the 4.84, if you're on the current firmware, you updated in February, you're as up to date as possible, then it's only going to work on the fat models. And then the slims with the 2000, 2001, and some of the 2005 serial number. Now, if you have a super slim, or if you have, you know, a slim with a 3000 model and you find out it doesn't work, there's still possibilities for you. However, it is my understanding that this mod is only usable up until 4.82. So if you've got a super slim that you haven't put online in a long time, it's been sitting in your closet or it's just been collecting dust and you think it's on 4.82 or less, don't connect it to the internet. Don't do an update. Find out what firmware it's on. And if it is on 4.82 or less, you'll be able to do a mod for that as well. So the first scenario I will go over is you have a 4.82 or less super slim or slim 2500 that is not going to be compatible with the 4.84 exploit. Now, like I said, if you're on 4.84 with a super slim, I believe, from my understanding, you are out of luck. But if you're on 4.82 or less, what you can do is you can do a HAN exploit, H-A-N. And I'll have a link to a tutorial down in the description for that. This will basically allow you to install a firmware on top of your official firmware, or an exploit on top of your official firmware. This doesn't allow you to do much, but it allows you to play backup games through packages, PKG files. Basically what a PKG file is, it's the file that's downloaded from the Sony PlayStation Store server, which you can acquire these packages through a program on your computer, and it'll download directly from the Sony PlayStation Store, as far as I understand. But of course, that file for the package doesn't actually help you if you don't have a HAN or a CFW console, because you're going to run into the fact that it's going to say that this product is not purchased on your account, you cannot install it, nada. Well, with the HAN console, you're basically able to override this and get this wrap file that allows you to install the game anyways, and basically gives you the purchase license for the game even though you did not purchase it through the PlayStation Store. And that's really the main thing you can do with the HAN consoles for something like a Super Slim, is you can install those backup games through PKG files, which are going to be games that were typically found on the PlayStation Store. So at some point in time, they were sold digitally and they received a software update. So take a game like Kingdom Hearts 2.5 or Kingdom Hearts 1.5, which were not released digitally, never received a title update, never received a software update. Those games would not be installable on a HAN PlayStation 3. And there aren't many games that lie outside of that scenario. Most games were released digitally or did receive a software update, but that's really all the HAN PlayStation 3s are going to allow you to do. The better scenario is if you can get a custom firmware PlayStation 3, which is what's up right now with the 4.84 exploit. The fact that on 4.84 on a fat model or slim model 2000 or 2001 and select 2005 models, you are able to actually install the custom firmware permanently on there, not as just something overlapping the official firmware, but really truly get it fully installed as the firmware on the console, is amazing, because the custom firmware is a lot better. Not only will it allow you to play those backups via the PKG files that are from the PlayStation Store, it'll also allow you to play ISOs, so basically a rip of the Blu-ray. So if I took my disc copy of Kingdom Hearts 2.5, which like I said was never released digitally, did not receive a title update, I could rip that disc onto my hard drive and play a backup ISO of it that way using a tool called Multiman. The other thing that I think is really amazing about Multiman, some of the other homebrew that I find fascinating, more so than any of the emulators, I'm not worried about playing SNES or Game Boy emulators or anything like that on a PlayStation 3. I have other devices that can do that. What I think is amazing about the PlayStation 3 is you're able to actually play PlayStation 2 ISOs on any PlayStation 3 that has CFW. Now, this doesn't just include the backwards compatible PlayStation 3s with the four USB slots that came out at the beginning of its lifespan. This even includes the Slim. I can play PS2 ISOs on my PS3 2001 Slim, which again, I think is one of the biggest selling points to me to want to have a CFW console instead of a hand console, just because it can play those PlayStation 2 ISOs. And while I do have a PlayStation 2 that's modded and has a hard drive in it and can play those ISOs, the fact that the PlayStation 3, which obviously can play PlayStation 1 games because it can do that out of the box on official firmware, the fact that this PlayStation 3 can play PlayStation 3 games, PlayStation 2 ISOs, and PlayStation 1 games is amazing. Now, can it run the PlayStation 2 ISOs consistently well? It depends on the title. Some titles do not run very well. Some titles may not run at all. But I know I did get Kingdom Hearts 2, the original one, running through an ISO for the PlayStation 2 copy, though I don't really play that copy because I'd rather play 2.5, the HD remake. But regardless, it's impressive to me that this actually works, and it's something that I wish Sony would have implemented themselves if the technology is there. I know it's not 100%. Like I said, not every single PlayStation 2 ISO will work on the PlayStation 3, but like with the Xbox originals and the Xbox 360, the fact that some of them work is something that I wish Sony would have implemented firsthand. There are also ways to play PSP games through a CFW PS3. Again, that's nothing I've really messed around with. I would probably rather play it on my PlayStation TV or on my actual PSP than try to mess around with the compatibility that it's gonna give me. Also, like I said, you can play, you know, SNES emulators, things like that on the PlayStation 3, but again, not an interest of mine. The main selling point to me to why you should have a CFW PS3 is the fact that it can play PlayStation 2 games. And because the CFW PlayStation 3s can run homebrew, there's also spoofing software available that'll allow you to go online and make it look like you have a newer, more recent firmware than you do in a way of trying to disguise it so that you can continue to play online. This is kind of a risky thing. Could get your console banned, but at this point, I guess what's really the difference? If you guys have any questions about modding the PlayStation 3, take a look at the tutorials I have linked down in the description. Those are some of the ones that I've followed for different PS3s that I've modded. Not maybe as recently as 4.84 because I haven't worked on one since this last exploit came out the other day. But these are fantastic creators on YouTube who have great tutorials for you to follow to help get things set up. These don't require any hardware changes. This isn't like a JTAG or an RGH on an Xbox 360. This is all done with a flash drive and some files. Makes me really easy for you guys. Helps you get the most out of your PlayStation 3 on what is really a dying console. Thank you guys for watching. I'm Bailey, and I will see you in the next video.